Going between the docks, I keep my bait wet. I don't care, man. Bait has to stay wet. 8-9 feet of water. Sonar, I look for anything. Maybe there's a crib out here. Maybe there's a tree that fell. You know, the ice brings it out there. Who knows what's out there? But when I'm fishing, those crib docks coming along here, got a floating raft, you think, maybe not. Fish suspend. Never go by it. My focus is the boathouse. With this deep stuff out here, a lot of times those big fish suspend. They're back almost against the dock. You gotta make a few pitches. Little guys, rock bass, don't get discouraged. You know why big largemouths sit by docks? Because there is stuff like that. Rock bass, perch, sunfish. And I slowly dissect this area here. Stay back, about 9 feet of water. What I can do here is I can throw it along the dock and swim it by. Work the whole area of the dock. Instead of being sideways, only having one square pitch. Just bouncing along. That little rodent boy, I tell you. When a fish is there, he's gonna hold it. He's gonna give me time to set hook. That's what's important. In clear water, it's very imperative to have baits that you trust. You know, watermelon meat, something with some green pumpkin, the blue craw, you know, it's got that green pumpkin as well with a little bit of blue iridescent, phenomenal stuff. But you know what I do? I throw all that logic out the window when it comes to this stuff. A little bit of green pumpkin here, a little black, but this side, it's called summer craw, bright chartreuse. You think clear water, everything natural? Uh-uh. Remember, you're putting it in spots where they're sitting and chilling. They don't really care that much about color, whatever. It's in their spot. They decide, look at it, look real. They put their mouth on it, it's soft, they eat it. Don't get all, you know, mixed up about, I have to match it exactly to a crayfish, a bluegill. Anything with some contrasting color of things that they eat, greens, red with green, green with blue, you can't lose. You know, your focus on the very first pitch has to be the most important. Don't take your eyes off it, just focus. That first pitch on these high potential areas, you know, they're target areas, ambush areas where bass are sitting. That first pitch, if you get it where it's supposed to go, there's a good chance if he's in any mood, whoa, he's gonna eat it, he's gonna grab it, he's gonna swirl at it. You know, you keep, pay attention to it. Never just pitch, look away, think about, oh, I'm gonna fish those pads over there, and maybe I should go back there. Oh, look at my line. By then you could have spit it out or whatever, swirled on it, you wouldn't even know if he's even there. Pay attention to that first pitch, and I guarantee you, a lot more of those fish are going to end up in the boat. Come on, fish. Where are you, Bubba? Where are you at? Huh? You ain't right there? How about over here? One of these deep cribs is going to produce a big fat pig. I mean a real big pig. Sun's high, it's warm, there's a storm coming. That usually turns them on hard. Come on, fish, give it to me. Nice big fatty. Man, these spots here are deep. Great hiding spots for a big fish, boy. Grab that bait and decide to just eat it up. And just swim away. Till I set the hook on that big crook. Like that one. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about right there. You got it? Yep. Good spot? Huh? Well, you got that, boy. Coming in the boat. Oh boy, bigger than I thought. Oh my God, eh? You see what I mean? That's what happens when you put the soft plastics, like the rodents, in the right spots. Look at the size of him, eh? He's big, big. You think maybe 3, 4, 5 pounds? I think he's got even more girth than that. That's why I use perfect plastics in summer on structure. You see, maybe the docks, everyone fishes them. Maybe they do. But when they're that big, you got to consider to do them, boy. Because they're well worth it, isn't it? Look at it. Look at the size of them. Girth, big, fat thing. Whew! Let's put you in there, big mama. Okay? Going in there. Let me get out of here. Now, is that worth it, running and gunning? Hey, is that worth it? Yes. Put it in. You know, I use a jig 90% of the time for reaction bites, shallow water, logs, sticks, you name it. Football finesse. But when it comes to deeper stuff and clear water, those soft plastics give me a bit more confidence thinking that if I throw it in sometimes, leave it. Shake it a bit, leave it. Fish comes over like this, looks at it, and then boom, he picks it up. He's not, repeat, not gonna throw it out. Gives you time to reel down, set, and do what I just did. This right here, that's what makes extreme angler, right there. Look at the belly on her, look at the back. Big old piggy. Okay, big girl, you make my day. Ready? Swimming away to the abyss. I'm gonna show you something what they're eating here, okay? Look at this. Now that's probably a rock bass, see? Face like this here, the tail, the head, regurgitated. Which one do you think spit that out, huh? I think it was the big girl. Nothing too big for largemouth bass. They can fit it in here, they'll eat it.